Welcome to St. James, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Today, this Good Friday, on this day, God saved us. Jesus died and rose for us, and in Him, whoever you are, whatever you've done, whatever you're afraid of, we have hope, we have peace in Christ. And we get to enjoy this beautiful Requiem, which we'll talk about later for just a moment, and its meaning. But for now, I pray you have peace, you find peace in Christ today by this beautiful music, and of course by our awesome Lord who would die for us. Let us say a prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank and we praise you for seeing us, for making us, creating us, but especially giving us forgiveness, life in Christ for free. Bless our hearts and bless our minds as we meditate upon what Christ did for us, that we see you are for us, that you love us, forgive us, and give us eternal life. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. And before we begin, I would like to, I know it's pre the wonderful music, but a round of applause for our musicians who've worked hard on this for the last couple of months. And our director of music and worship here, Kodrit Bursad. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Buddhists, having procured a band of soldiers and some officers from the chief priests and the Pharisees, went there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that would happen to him, came forward and said to them, "Who do you seek?" They answered him, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus said to them, "I'm he." Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. When Jesus said to them, "I am he," they drew back and fell to the ground. So he asked them again, "Whom do you seek?" And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he. So if you seek me, let these men go."
The high priest then questioned Jesus about his disciples and his teaching. Jesus answered him, "I have spoken openly to the world. I have always taught in synagogues and in the temple, where everyone comes together. I have said nothing in secret. Why do you ask me? Ask those who have heard me what I said to them. They know what I said." When he had said these things, one of the officers standing by struck Jesus with his hand, saying, "Is that how you answer the high priest?" Jesus answered him, "If what I said is wrong, bear witness about the wrong. But if what I said is right, why do you strike me?" Annas then sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself. So they said to him, "You also are not one of his disciples, are you?"
He denied it and said, I am not. One of the servants of the high priest, a relative of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked, Did I not see you in the garden with him? Peter again denied it, and at once a rooster crowed.
Then he was brought to Pilate. Pilate said to him, So you are a king? Jesus answered, You say that I'm a king. For this purpose I was born, and for this purpose I have come into the world, to bear witness to the truth. Everyone who's of the truth listens to my voice. Pilate said to him, What's truth? After he had said this, he went back outside to the people and told them, I find no guilt in him, but you have a custom that I should release one man for you at the Passover. So who do you want me to release to you? The king of the Jews? They cried out again, not this man, but Barabbas. Now Barabbas was a robber.
Thank you.
From then on, Pilate sought to release him, but the people cried out, "If you release this man, you are not Caesar's friend. Everyone who makes himself a king opposes Caesar." So when Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out and sat down on the judgment seat at a place called the Stone Pavement, and in Aramaic, Gabbatha. Now it was the day of preparation of the Passover. It was about the sixth hour. He said to the people of Israel, "Behold your king." They cried out, "Away with him, away with him, crucify him." Pilate said to them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priests answered, "We have no king but Caesar." So he delivered him over to them to be crucified.
Thank you.
In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. What in the world does this requiem have to do with Good Friday, this funeral service with Jesus? Mozart wrote this, was given this, commissioned this for, many of you might know the story, right? For a mysterious person gave him this job. And as he began to compose it, he was sick, felt ill. At some point, believed that this service, a requiem, which is a funeral service, music for a funeral service, was his own. And as he was writing this, you can just maybe hear him in these words, "Lord, have mercy, forgive me of my sins, save me." And sure enough, Mozart died. And, sorry to say this, much of this is not Mozart. Someone else finished it for him. Good Friday is a funeral service as well of our Lord Jesus. We think of why do bad things happen to good people? One might say that can only be said of Christ, who loved his neighbor, whoever they were, and loved God, and yet was killed, and yet died. And today we, across the globe, people come together on this day that Christ died for our sins and mourn over the suffering and the name-calling, the mocking, the carrying of the cross alone, everyone else leaving him, betraying him, denying him, and alone going up to that cross and finally saying, "It is finished." So today is a funeral service for Jesus of sorts. Not that he was caught off guard like we are by death, but in fact, he came to lay down his life for you, because whether you believe it or not, whether it feels like it or not, God loves you. God made you. Despite us, God forgives you of all of your sins by the blood of Jesus. This funeral service is a testimony not simply of sadness, looking at the cross and seeing this is the essence of humanity. This is what we do to one another. This is what we do to God. But today we see, in fact, an incredible love of God. And from now on, the cross is not a sign simply of our betrayal, denial, or sin, but of God's love for us. Today is Mozart's funeral service. Today is Jesus' funeral service. But today is your funeral service. This is yours. This is Christ intermingled with Mozart, intertwined his death with him, so he has yours. When Jesus died, you died. When he was punished, we were punished. Painlessly, Christ took it for us so that we are okay, as Mozart was, with death, knowing that Jesus died in his place and Jesus rose again. So we can stand here and look at our own sins, knowing they are finished, they are paid for. And we can stand even at our own funeral service, knowing we are forgiven by the blood of Jesus and we will rise again. May you leave here with that peace and hope, and not fear of God or fear of your own guilt. It is finished. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his garments, divided them into four parts, one part for each soldier, also his tunic, for the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from top to bottom. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see whose it shall be." This was to fulfill the scripture which says, "They divided my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots."
After this, Jesus, knowing that all was now finished, said, to fulfill the scripture, "I thirst." A jar full of sour wine stood there, so they put a sponge full of the sour wine on a hyssop branch and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, "It is finished," and he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
Thank you.
After these things, Joseph of Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus, but secretly for fear of the leaders, asked Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. Pilate gave him permission, so he came and took away his body. Nicodemus also, who earlier had come to Jesus by night, came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 75 pounds in weight. So they took the body of Jesus and bound it in linen cloths with the spices, as is the burial custom of the Jewish people. Now in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden a new tomb in which no one had yet been laid. So, because of the day of preparation, since the tomb was close at hand, they laid Jesus